Oh my days. Okay. Okay. Oh boy. My match went out. Oh no.
Hello you guys, my name is Alistair, and today I have something a bit different planned for you. If you haven't been able to tell already from my social media, World War One is my main area of study and interest. My second love, however, is horror. And the good thing about that is that the two occasionally find a nice intersection where horror can kind of build on the existing horrors of war. Such as in this game I'm about to play for you called Under Depths of Fear. This is one of three games that I've been waiting for that utilizes World War One as the sort of main background for the game. In terms of horror games that concern war, World War One tends to get overlooked a lot, and World War Two takes up about, you know, 90% of the spotlight. So it's really nice to see when creators utilize World War One, especially since a lot of the reanimation tropes that you usually see for war games do stem from World War One. So this game, you play as a traumatized war veteran called Alexander Dockter, and you are exploring a sinking ocean liner. However, there are apparently some things that are roaming these decks that you do need to watch out for. I'm super excited to see what kinds of things they've done with this game. It looked pretty amazing from the trailers, and I did do a couple things with the demos as well. So, without further ado, let's begin. Right, let me turn it up so you can actually see. Here we go. I did have footage for this initially, but unfortunately my files were all corrupt and weren't compatible with the editing program, so I have to redo this. What kind of shoes I got on?
Blasted door will not open anymore. We can't carry the damn bastard up on the stairs.
Aye, leave the bloody fool. No use for a man like him at home. Let the bastard rot in his chair.
For a second, I thought I had wooden blocks for feet. Oh, it's a wheelchair. Right. Can't see. Stuff mess. Pick up. What is it? Canteen? Thirsty. Alright. Get a beverage. Now we're prepared. But the first time I tried to play through some of this, I completely missed some of the stuff. There was so many jump scares that I just completely overlooked because I was just looking around. I didn't see it. Let's see here. Little, hello. Pick it up. Thank you. No more. Right, button here. No. Got these matches. Pick up. opened. Okay. Put it down. Alright. Got a lock. Nope. Got some here. 6. This way. Hello. Oh, wait. No. No. Scroll gently. No. Oh my god. No. Go. A little bit. No. Yes. Blew my eardrums. Okay. Nope. Critical medical file 3. Oh my god. Rotate. No. Something's wrong with the... Come on. Okay. No. Redo that. Unknown cavalry soldier found conscious with 4-9 iron rod planted through brain. Patient was transported nearest departure to England within 12 hours of discovery. Day 1, transport was conscious, cleared delusional as a result of injury. Patient started developing infection around wound area and slowly started screaming that developed the ooh gosh. And patient was found dead in his ward bed. Wild. It's right there.
What is your life?
Something. Oh, that opened. Keys. Go to the other door. No, thanks. Crouch. Can't see. Look, I know I have matches, but I don't want to waste them. Did I make it? I went in a circle. Such little fingers, can't reach the keys. Going down. This would be incredibly terrifying. I don't know, just being on a ship all by yourself. Oh my god, that scared me for just a moment. Please, just stop making noise. Got some matches. God fucking. Please don't. Closed? Yeah.
As a soldier, what did you reckon your expectations to be?
Well, we all went to fight. We left our families, our bloody lives. Come on. We needed everyone for our king. Every bloody day they said, if one stays, we all suffer. Don't delude your way out of it. It will happen. Let your soul rest. That what happened will never happen again. Bloody hell. If only we knew what a killer a bloody coward can be. I know what you're looking for. The way out? Never. This will never end.
Keys to a door. Alright.
Can we go through now?
Oh god. Oh, it's so dark. Oh my god. Gotta be to this door, I think. What's that sound? Should I even be doing this? What am I looking at? God, what? What does that mean? Okay, I don't know. I'm just gonna go back. Oh. Yeah. Go back. Did I literally go right past these doors? Wow. Alright. The lights turn on. Boilers. Wait. Oh, it's a ball. Touch these? But I should be touching them, but... What the ladder sound? What the hell is that? Is that the guy with the metal rod through his head? Oh my days! Oh, don't. What? Steam. Go. Go. Let's get up. Is that it? Hopefully. What? Oh, it's just a door. Stop. What? Oh no. Oh. Pick it up. Pick it up. Oh. Hello. Oh. That noise at me. God, what am I looking back? Don't ever do that. Oh, the water's going. Please go. It matches, no anything. Oh shh, come on mate. Go. There we go. What do these do? You know what? We're gonna pull all of them. Is this a good idea? Probably not. What's that music? Don't do that to me. Okay, don't make that noise at me. It's fine. Oh, I saw stars. No, that's not fair. I saw stars, no. Do not run into door. Oh, come on. Some music. There we go. Today's the first day in the front since we were training. Quite impressed by the conditions, not all as expected. And with this, we must defeat the front after this over. The team members have said get along quite well with these chaps. Share a spirit for adventure, although there's one man in particular who's quite concerned to me. I believe his name to be Alexander. He visualizes a man who has no ambition for this war, and worst of all, already seems frightened throughout the entire day. I'm truly hoping that he will man up. An officer clearly told us that every man needs to work together. Okay. So that's one thing that always interests me about World War is the talk about the supernatural during wartime. Can I shut this off?
This need not be a solitary topic for you. Before your departure, there's a need for you to dispense with. Now tell me. I heard them speak of it. He was there. There was always general word of his existence. Put on this arm and chased the those who bent for themselves only. Never had I seen him. Now when did you hear of him? And what was the name he went by? What Dort. They spoke of him after a murder was committed. After countless lives were lost in the actions of one. They said he roamed that man's land, slowly peering into every man's lifeless heart. Those who still live no more after he had passed. Searching he was, they said, for the one who sided with his very own country, Lucifer himself. That's the lesson you can hear in the cloven hooves. Now these are just dark tales, possibly from you alone. Careful to speak of evil this way. One doesn't know the terrors of sudden death until you see it. Darkness arises long before men are buried in their graves. Those cloven feet will find those of guilt. Okay, take it. Sweep it. This will not construct our world. Make sure it's gone.
Hey. Damn. I wonder what this guy did. At first I thought he might be some kind of, like a conscript, because this does take place in 1917. And then, you know, they do, this game seems to be centered on the subject of cowardice, which... oh my god. Hello? Dare not. Thank you. Yeah, I don't remember what I was going to say before. I completely lost my train of thought. Alright. We need to move this. Please. Trying to remember what I was going to say. Oh, it's a ship tilting. I was like, what I was going to say was, I'm always very, when I hear a game or some sort of World War One subject is going to be about criticizing cowardice. Because it tends to be whenever someone sort of tries to address it, I usually think it's incredibly unfair, knowing how young a lot of the boys were that died, and also the fact that a great many of them were conscripted, obviously, after 1916 and had no choice but to be there. You're making a 14-year-old go up against a machine gun. You know, that's... I don't know. Then again, I'm very... Don't tell me to crouch in the tables to hide from danger. That's not a good sign. Then again, I'm very anti-war, so... Oh, no. Okay. Game didn't like that. Hello? You know, but they apparently all the cowardice charges were dismissed actually quite recently. Which, did it really take you that long to decide on something like that? You know, it's just, I don't know. Hello?
Oh my days, okay. Okay. Oh boy, my match went out! Oh no, oh my god. Holy crap, where am I going? I don't know.
You know, so I hope this isn't the case where it's trying to demonize a 15-year-old kid from running away or from feeling afraid. Got some keys. I do wonder, I thought initially this character might be an officer though, but apparently he's not. They released a lot of beta footage and demos and stuff for this game, so it kind of got me a bit confused, but at one point I thought his main weapon was a Webley.
Oh my god.
Ratatouille's on this ship. Oh, that's not good. I'm gonna get people telling me his name's Remy, I know. You know, but I thought he was an officer. I guess he's not, because it sounds like he's... I don't know, he just... was put in a platoon at one point. As just a private, I don't know. Oh. Daddy, why did you murder your platoon? Yeah, see, this is why it was strange, because it sounds like he led them into danger. Which, leading is usually something I would expect an officer to be doing. So I don't really know what rank he is. And it's honestly been super hard to track down a lot of info about this game as well, because it was quite unknown before pretty much the last couple of months. These crosses, this is awful. Next room.
that away now, mate. Alright. That doesn't sound good. Oh. There's like the, faces before reconstruction. The plasters. Yep, it's a reanimation trope. Facial construct case 4A. Some platoon member was retrieved after fatal attack and would implement medical revitalization experiment following procedure according to Second Life Act. Face was successfully mastered with plaster reconstruction. Ooh. Yeah. I'm wondering, I've only been able to read into this so much, but I'm wondering if what's coming after you. I'm pretty sure that's the reanimated soldiers, but I wonder actually if they're reanimated soldiers who happen to be from your platoon that you supposedly led into danger. Of course. Everything is locked. And the keys are always on different floors, conveniently. It's just the ship. Sorry. Right or left? It's correct. You know, this ship might have been sinking, but they sure had enough time to be able to make sure to lock the doors behind them. Oh. He's escaped the grave. You'll never escape those he left to rot. We're always behind you. Just watch. Is that not another one?
No.
Ooh. Ooh. Memoir. Hello? Sir? Oh, don't. Okay. Ooh. So, oh. F. Give. Yeah, is the water rising? Yep. Water is getting pretty high. This way? Yes, I think so. Oh god, please don't drown. Oh no. No. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. We came in from that way. Mm-mm. Can that guy come down here and open this up for me? Excuse me, sir. Do you have the keys? Uh-oh. Whoa, no. Water's getting a bit high. Shit. Oh. Oh, shit. Go, 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 go. Got a key. See, how come I can see in these vents but not the other ones? I spoke too soon. Hey, why do you want to go down? Oh, too late now. This one? Nope. Right. Nope. You could not pay me money to do this. Just open it up with a key. Electrical supplies. Just where a little friend went. You almost got me there.
fuse. Need some like keys or something, right? Oh, close. I feel like I whip around too fast. Ooh, there we go. Use. Got it. Now, this should work, right? Lovely. Right. Upper decks. All right. I'm gonna keep going for just a little bit longer. Oh. Maybe not. Okay. I had a dream about a place that looked like this once. This fan sounds like it's gonna break. What is this? Oh, swimming pool? Is it holding a corn dog? What is that? Oh, it's a feather. Alright, let's be on door number one. Nothing. It must be a swimming pool, because you see those little changing rooms. Oops, some matches. Perfect. A bin. No. Oh, please no. You know, I was just feeling a bit safer, but, Oh my god, mate! Oh my god! What do I do? What do I do? Oh my god. What do I do? God, we just hide. We just hide. My heart is pounding. Oh my god, my heart is pounding. The color, like, drained from my face. Her white as a sheet. Oh my god, my hands are like going. What do I do? Okay, well, we gotta look sometime. Oh my god, I think it was just a little scare. Maybe, I don't know. Actually, don't say that. No, I don't want to jinx myself. Oh, please. Please, a key? Okay, hold on. I can't see a thing. It's gotta be a key in one. Oh! Oh! Oh, thank god! Please, no. I hear something breathing. Oh my god. Please, please be dead. Please be kind to me. Why is he giving me that? I didn't even want to turn around. Someone's in here. Please don't. Oh my god, mate. Do I hear something? Oh my god, I hear something breathing. Please be delicate with me. Oh my god! Oh my god!
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Oh my god! Okay. Death is fine. Okay, no. We have to get through this. Too many of this. I don't know what to do. Because if he's going to be in that room, there's... Okay, no. We have to observe our exits. We have to be smart about this. Okay, no. There's no getting past that. That's locked. There's no crouching that can be done. We've got to try and run past him then. There's no other way. No, because if we... I feel like he'd get us if we run past him. Okay, the lights are going to go out. There's going to be some spooky sounds, but it's okay. We're just going to calmly walk, and we're just going to go in here, and we're going to crouch, and we're going to cry a little bit. Just sit here for a moment. I'm not leaving this spot. Just gonna see you for the rest of the game. Now we're gonna just slowly check. Okay, nothing there. So don't stand up that fast ever again. Just carefully give a little peek. Okay. Alright. Please don't be in here. Okay. Here's the key. Okay, we're just gonna hide in the bin. I'm just a piece of trash. Okay. Okay, we're just gonna not even look that direction. If he can't see us, we can't see him. No, it's the other way around. Is that open to the left? No, it's not. No, I gotta get... No, this has gotta be the door. Wait a minute. Oh, please work. Please don't grab my ass as I back up a bit. Okay, ready? No. We gotta go. Did I do it? Oh, we did it. Oh, thank... Oh, gosh. Okay. Okay. Right. I'm just at least glad to be out of that. Okay. Is that music or just ambience? Whatever it is, I don't like it. Alright. Don't know what that did. It probably opened that door, actually. Right? No. Oh, yes. Please let me out of here. Gotta go. I hate hallways. Hello. I just need to go down this hallway. Just for a sec. Just a little bit. I hate this so much. Okay, we can do this. He's gonna come flinging at the screen or something. Oh, dude, I can't do it. Oh my god, maybe I just don't look at it. Oh my god, mate. I hate this so much. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna close my eyes and I'm gonna run at it. Oh my god, dude, I can't. Does this door open? Can you please just let me get through this one door? Oh, does it open? Oh.
Okay, there's an open door right there. We're gonna go 1, 2, 3, we're gonna run. Ready? 1, 2, 3, run! Oh god! Okay, okay. I'm just gonna crouch and cry. I think I'm gonna stop here for right now because it's getting a bit intense, so we'll save this for the next episode. Well, so far I am very impressed with this game. I love what they've done with it. Right up my alley in terms of a horror game I would love to play. So if you guys want to play this too, it's available on Steam right now, and I hope you guys enjoy it as much as I do. If you do play it, I will be finishing out this game. I'll release this in probably a few episodes, I think. I don't know how far I'm in right now, but hopefully we can finish it. Alright, well, I will see you guys in the next episode then. I hope you enjoyed.